I'm a pit bull, and I approve this message. I'm a pit bull, and I approve this message. Hey, good morning, afternoon, and evening, someplace all over the world. I'm Foster Carter, and welcome to Conversations with the Pit Bull. All right, today we have a wonderful, special friend and family with our show, Antonio, the Greyhound. There he is.
There we go.
And look at that outfit, man. You know what? I'm so glad. You know, I would have been so embarrassed because I was going to wear the same thing today.
You guys would have been twins. Darn.
I know, and that would have been so embarrassing. Look at that. You know? Except for he looks better because my mask was blue. So, you know, that's like, look at that boy, man. It's been a while since you guys are with us. Thank you so much for coming in.
Yeah, no problem. We were excited when Paula asked us to be on.
Yeah, well, you know, Paula, what can we say? So, hey, today we got a special little thing. I got some glasses because we're still celebrating Danny's birthday, you know. But before we're waiting on Paula to get in here. Hey, Paula. There she is.
Good morning.
Technology is amazing, isn't it? How are you today?
Wet. It's raining here.
Yeah? Well, that's a good thing, right? You guys need the rain?
Yeah, we really do need the rain.
Yeah.
The grass is crunchy, so yeah, we need it.
Well, we got a couple of things that we're going to cover. Danny is on his way, and he'll be here shortly, as usual, running late. Two things. One, as a lot of you guys know, we are leaving rescue topics or rescue support in terms of trying to get involved to change the atmosphere because I don't think, you know, people want it to change. For me, the hate and the disrespect and the lack of compassion for human beings. Everyone says, oh, they're compassionate for dogs. And so, no, it's
no,
not.
They're not.
No, they really don't care about the dogs. So in order to maintain our safety, because we as a show, personally, myself and Paula, that's why Danny's not on Facebook. We got drugged into the darkness, and, you know, I've had a wonderful life and a successful, you know, everything that I've done in many lives. Never, ever, ever in my life have I seen or experienced this kind of, attack. Now, they throw the word bully and trolls out there, you know, but it's deeper than that, you know. You know, it's sad. You know, they should call it sad people. But personally, I want to say two things real quick, maybe three. One, I want to apologize. I want to apologize for anyone who hasn't understood me and for getting drugged into the smuck. You know, I haven't attacked anybody since I was in Vietnam. And Paula, I started you know, doing defensive attacks. And that's so out of my character and so out of what we do. What you and I have done, what Danny and I have done, what the whole family, Cheryl, Fred Cray, you know, everybody that we've talked to around the world, everyone we've had in this studio, you know, it's about love. You know, I was thinking about when we had Rosie in the studio, you know, and that was where we started and came from, you know, with love and supporting what everyone is doing. And just out of our 300 hours of shows this last month, you know, it took on a whole different kind of vibe, which is not what we do and who we are. And my partner and right hand and the best part of me just walked in. Doctor, how are you, sir?
I'm good. I'm late.
Good. That's all right. Well, you ain't never late, you know. So I just
got donuts.
Nope, but. So, you know, people have said a lot of things about me that they don't know and is not true. And you guys can live with that. Everybody's right. I'm wrong. I know nothing. But I do want to say I wish you all love, you know, period, and peace and happiness on however it goes. And the second thing is this. I think from our month of looking into what's happening and the causes and different things, I think that the pledges need to leave because money is the root of all evil, as they say. And I think all of this comes down to pledges because all of the rescue people really are fighting about money and the money that good people, really caring, loving people who care about the animals are putting up for the dogs. And I was discussing with Paula how if the pledge is left and it was a rescue and shelter, Paula, do you want to explain that or should I? Okay. If the pledge money was set up at the shelters for the dogs and it didn't go to humans because as one lady stated, you know, dogs don't get saved on Facebook. Dogs get saved by good rescue people. And if they change or you guys change, because I have nothing to do with it, you know, anymore. We're about, you know, showcasing people and their good work and what they're doing. But I think that the pledges are the problem. And that's where all of the drama and the hate and the greed stems from. So that's what I say about that. Now, the other thing is, as a community, if you guys want to help, and that's not what I want, it is Sandra Gannon, if you guys don't know, her dog got out, was lost, and was shot by a neighbor. And we're going to have her on Tuesday to explain it and go into more detail because this is something that the community does need to support if there is a community. And, you know, that might be my own fantasy and imagination and wish list. But if you could contact Shannon and or also call the DA and just say what's happening with the investigation of the dog that was shot, you know, and what was that baby's name?
Linda.
Linda, that's right.
Linda.
Right, Linda, if you just call them and the sheriff, just so they don't sweep it under, because the details are ugly, because, you know, the police found the dog and they didn't bring the dog's body in. They left it out there to try to decompose, couldn't tell, you know, what was happening. And as I understand it, and Shannon is, Sandra is going to be here. Yeah, you know, I can't remember my own name most of the time. So, but that phone number is 760-366-4175, 760-366-4120, and just ask what's going on with the investigation around the dog Linda that was shot. because they removed the tags and the collar and left the dog, and because it was shot, you know, if it decomposed, you can't tell a lot. But I understand that the distance was, you know, like 300 yards or something like that. So somebody had to have a high power rifle type of dog. Anyway.
And a good scope.
And a great scope. You would know more about that because you don't know. Paula's got a whole arsenal. Boy, any burglars out there, don't go near the Archer house. That's all I can tell you, you know. Hey.
Yep.
Phil, how are you, sir?
I'm good, brother. How you doing?
Good. Before we get in with Antonio, and what's happening with you? Anything new?
Man, everything's cool. You know what I mean? I got some trainers from a group called Master Dog Trainers. Mm-hmm. They're going to come out and do an evaluation with my American Bulldogs tomorrow, so I'm excited about that.
Yeah.
I've been having trouble walking them just because they're so big and strong, mm-hmm. and they're in a new area and neighborhood, so mm-hmm. trying to get them a little bit of basic training, because they're cool around my house. I'm like, they know everything, and they sit and they stay and they do all that, but yeah. It's like, as soon as you take them out the gate, if they even sniff a squirrel or rabbit, right. another dog or whatever, they, you know, yeah. then it becomes like, you know, I wasn't trying to go to Gold's Gym. I just wanted to take you for a walk. You know what I'm saying?
Well, that's yeah.
So I figured I'd get some professional help.
That's right.
And check these out. They've been referred pretty highly, and they seem like they have a comprehensive program. So I'm gonna interact with them tomorrow, and then maybe if we have a good interaction, maybe I'll bring them on the show and we can see.
Yeah, absolutely.
We haven't had a trainer on in a while since yeah. What was your boy at back there, and they used to send us the videos and stuff.
Drayton, Mike.
We need to have Drayton on again. I like that dude.
Yeah, absolutely.
But you know, that's the newest thing with me on the dog front.
Yeah,
you know,
well, it's just about socializing them. Yeah. You know, because they haven't had that.
So yeah, it's one of those things where they, you know, I took over ownership of them from my dad after he passed away. Mm-hmm. So my dad's kind of like old school and just kept them in the backyard, and mm-hmm. they were there to protect the fortress. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But mm-hmm. they didn't. You know, they don't know anything about a dog park right. or a leash right. or whatever. Right. It's like they go down, hop in the car, and go get some ribs, and that's about the extent of their right. whatever. But now with me, you know, I have a different understanding of
what they need
and what their lifestyle can and should be like. And, you know, I'm having to deal with their previous life, so to speak.
Exactly.
Mine, too. You know, I've been in transition as well. So, but now that I'm finally got a little bit of stability and stuff like that, I'm going to try to get improve their life and get them some of the basic training so that they don't go crazy when they see
there you go. Exactly.
Angelica Antonio just walking around. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Hey, and I just want to put it out there that my daughter is looking for a English Bulldog, right, Paula? Mm-hmm. Yeah. So anybody know any English Bulldogs, you know, she wants a puppy, you know, so if any rescues out there know of those, then contact us, because they got another dog that was older, you know, 3 years older before, and they had a lot of problems, and I've helped them, you know, work the dog in like what you're doing. So just put that out there. So how are you?
Hey there. We're doing good here.
Look at those glasses. Look at those glasses. So what's been happening with you since the last time you were with us?
Well, we decided to take the summer off, and we'll be continuing some of our work with rescue, raising funds, mm-hmm. and promoting rescue over store sales of
mm-hmm.
puppies.
Mm-hmm. Is this predominantly greyhounds?
We work mostly with Italian Greyhounds, yeah, but we also like to kind of promote some of the other rescue groups that mm-hmm. maybe not be as well known, like National Mill Dog Rescue and the mm-hmm. like, Hazel Jane's Dog Blessings.
Ah, okay, so you took the summer off, so that means vacation?
Rest.
Sleep.
Much needed rest.
Needed rest. Yes, I totally understand that. You know, so the and if I may ask, how are you doing?
I am okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm hanging in there and taking it day by day.
Yeah.
I've kind of been facing a couple new challenges lately, but, you know, just doing the best I can. And I got my partner here, and, you know, we just take it day by day.
Yeah. How old is Antonio now?
He is turning 8 this December.
8?
Yeah.
We're the same age. That's amazing. That's amazing, man.
Got a little bolt to the gray, right?
So, hey, one of the people who, you know, was misunderstanding me and who I am, said something that was like, you know, ridiculous about, said, I come to the show drunk every day. Yeah. Well, here's today is Danny's birthday. So, yeah.
We know us, you're brothers. Right. We celebrate all month. So.
That's right.
My birthday is actually at 7. You know whose birthday it is? My grandma. Happy birthday, right? Grandma.
Yeah. Hey. Hey.
How many of y'all out there can say 93?
That's right.
Bang. Bang, 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 bang.
Who's on the phone?
She's been doing that. You know, happy birthday, Grandma. And I want to give a shout-out to my good buddy, John. John's getting married on Sunday, so
hey.
Props to you, brother man.
Welcome to the club.
Angelica's birthday was yesterday.
Yeah. Is that right?
Yeah, Leo's in the house.
Wait a minute. You didn't tell us that. Are you drinking?
Sorry?
Are you drinking?
Oh, no.
I didn't think so. We're going like Kathleen and Hoda in here.
We're both underage.
Feeling good, Lewis?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Who's on the phone, sir? Hello? Who's on the phone? Hello?
Oh, Foster. It's Heather. Sorry.
Oh.
I was drinking.
Oh, well, there you go. Welcome to the club, you know? How are you? Oh, before.
Not really.
Hey, before we take your call... we also want to lift the glass to Cheryl, and she's probably at work, you know, because you guys celebrate a birthday together.
Yep.
So Cheryl Herka, who is a wonderful pit bull advocate and part of our family around here, and she's been working hard and doing things. So happy
my brother
birthday.
Bob's birthday is on the 20th. So
is that
Leo's,
right?
Leo's
hey, Bob.
In the house doing a thing. You know what
hey.
I mean?
Yay!
Got a Leo right here too.
Yeah.
41 yesterday.
That's right.
So Heather, what's happening?
What was that, Foster?
I say, what's going on with you?
You know, I'm feeling your guys' vibe today. I'm exhausted, and you know, I pretty much. That's it with that. I'm not dealing with this anymore. I'm just going to continue on, and I want to update you that all three of those Dobermen, and this was through teamwork, just to show you what you said about pledges. We don't do them. We do what's best for the dog. The two Dobermans in California, I named because the shelter didn't. I was not happy about that, and they haven't assessed them in months, but... one we named Sophia Loren. She's going at 9 a.m. tomorrow. And Luciano, oh, yeah, I'm from New York, right?
Mm-hmm.
He is being adopted today. And Jovi in Miami-Dade was also adopted. And this was done through one of the cross-posting groups I gifted to Paula and Yukiko and many of us working together. And what it took was... not pledges, not this. I said, anything you guys need, let's get them out. I'd like to spare them a 4,000-mile trip here. But I'm going to be flying out to visit you guys in a couple weeks.
Come
I'm
on
personal.
In. Come
what,
on
what's
in.
It?
I say, come on in.
Let I know.
Us,
who's
let us
gonna
know.
Put, who's going to put me and Capone up? Because we're coming by to look at opening a business, get our rescue going.
Well, what we'll do, I tell you, is, you know, let me know some dates. You know, we'll do that off the show air and, you know, and talk about that and work it out, okay?
Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to it because, well, maybe coming out there for good. So, but Yep, I'm on you with all that, and I'm the same as you. I just went out and found positive rescues, and we just did it. That's the
only way. Let me ask you before, because my engineer is signaling me that we need to do Paula's dogs real quick.
Save the dogs too, Paula, that Rizzy song.
Yeah, before we take a break for our wonderful, 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 super wonderful sponsor, Pitbull Energy Drink. Let me ask you, the show about the toxic thing that you're going through with your house, and is that helping?
Well, I'm so low-key today. I was at the doctor's all day yesterday, and it's affected me. I've managed to do pretty well with my fur kids, but my doctor's prescription, actually, aside from the testing, is move to California because the weather, get away from the toxic waste.
That's in Buffalo. For those of you that don't know, you can go to our YouTube channel and see the show Toxic Waste in Buffalo is Killing Dogs and People.
Helped. And, so far I haven't gotten anything about the house or any representatives or anyone. But in the meantime, I'm not going to sit here and die. I'm going to keep on, and it just motivates me more. And I want to thank you all for getting that out.
No problem, dear. We're glad that we could help.
I love you guys, and I will have your back no matter what. But I'm just like you, that these, whatever I call them, haters, they've just drained me. And you know what they did? They just motivated me, not taking off. I'm going to move on to the next state and the next state, all in between.
There you go.
So watch out.
There you go. Well, love will always prevail. So anyone who is waking up angry and mean and has the time and the desire to try to destroy people, all we can do is just feel sorry for them and wish them love and healing and all of that, because I know I don't have time for it. It's like, it's too much stuff going on.
God bless me, Paula, and many more have been through hell.
Right.
And you know what I did? I just ignored them.
Yeah, well,
we saved three lives.
Right, but it's that's right. Well, it's like I don't know the answer. The answer is for all of them to come up with. It's sad, and I do know this though. I do know that it's gonna eventually go back to how rescue was before Facebook, because with all the lawsuits that Facebook is gonna be facing and has been facing, with all of the defamation of character and slander and all of this different stuff.
They don't do anything about it.
Yeah, well, they will. Things are, and the dogs are going to lose in the long run because they aren't going to be able to do the same thing on Facebook, and that's sad for the rescue community and for the dogs. So with the dogs, Paula Archer, you have some dogs for us. You're playing with your dogs.
Paula, where are these dogs? Because we may be able to help you with these, I hope.
That's right. You got dogs today, dear?
Of course I do.
Well,
I live for the dogs.
I know. That's what I heard about you. That's too bad. All right. So you one of the few, And with that, I do want to say, everyone who has shown us love and supported us, and those of you who have been tortured and tormented, I suggest legal action. We are still there for you, and any way we can assist off of Facebook, I'll still be in contact with you guys. But everyone needs to know you're destroying people, and that's not a good thing, So. Let's go to the dogs, man. Let's get some babies some homes.
Okay, I'm ready when Chris is. Chris, you ready?
Yeah, he's ready.
Okay, good deal. This first one that we have up today is Will. Will is a pit mix. He's around six to 9 months old. 39 pounds. He is heartworm negative, and he is off of hold today, which means he can be killed anytime after today, and that is at the discretion of the shelter. Next up, Oh, and this one breaks my heart. Oh, this is Freddie. Freddie is a pit mix. He's 9 to 12 months old. He's 52 pounds, which that's a little on the small side, but, you know. And he is heartworm positive. There is treatment for that. It's not a death sentence, as some people think it is. His hold was up on 8-9, and he can be killed at any time after his hold time is up. Next, we have Luke. Luke is my baby. I would love to bring him home with me. He is a pit mix. He's a year old, 63 pounds, kind of chunky the way I like him, heartworm negative, and he is off of hold tomorrow, 8:15. Now we have Teddy. Teddy is a brindle. You know, I love them brindle babies. He's a year to 2 years old. He's around 50 pounds. He's heartworm negative. And his hold time was up on August the 1st. Now we have Moto. Moto is a pit mix, a year old, and he is heartworm positive. His hold time was up 7:31 and can be killed any time after that. Next, we have Owen. Owen baby is a pit mix. He is a year old. He is heartworm negative, and he needs out of the shelter as soon as possible. Now we have Zorro. Zorro is a year to 2 years old. He's a pit mix, although you can't really tell from the picture. Anyway, Zorro needs out of the shelter as soon as possible also. Now this next little baby we have, well, he's not a little baby. He's a year old, but he's only 50 pounds. His name is Barry. Barry is heartworm negative, and he also is urgent to get out of the shelter. Now we have Bam Bam. Oh, this gorgeous guy is about a year old. He is heartworm positive, and like I said, it's treatable, not a death sentence. So he needs out of the shelter as soon as possible. And these dogs, oh, I have one more. Sorry, Diamond. Diamond, she is the only female out of the group. She is 9 to 12 months old. She's heartworm negative, and she needs rescue as soon as possible. You can see her little collar there. They've woven pink ribbon around her as a bauble. These dogs are at Ruin Creek Animal Protection Society of Henderson, North Carolina. The phone number, if you are interested in any of these dogs, and if you are, you need to call today. Their number is 252-432-4072. Again, that number is 252-432-4072. That's Henderson, North Carolina. Pick up that phone and call and help these babies. That's right. All I have for today, guys.
All right. So it was something else, too, that I just have to say. I brought Wendy. I got her to come on the show and agree to step out of rescue, and we were gonna get the dogs homes that she had, Paula. And
yes,
we spent the whole show, you know, putting together stuff for the California dogs that were left, because Texas had been taken care of, and it was about the dogs in the city where she is. And she agreed on air to, you know, step out of rescue. So the focus turned to the dogs and getting the dogs. And I just want to clear something up, that because I had spoken with this person, and actually you were on the second conference call, Paula, Amanda Coates, or
yes,
something to that effect. When I talked to her on Monday before the show, the agreement was about the dogs. If Wendy signed over a release or transfer form for other rescues to take these dogs and put them in, you know, try to get them homes. She was the person that was going to help. That's why I announced that on the show. When
right
after the show, it turned into another caveat about Wendy signing some form of getting out of rescue for her in order to do it. That is not true.
It was made into something other than the dogs.
Right. And that's sad, you know, because...
And that wasn't the deal. That was not the deal.
And for me, it appeared to be, you know, someone wanting to take credit for driving Angel's journey out of rescue, which is sad and sick. You know, none of us are police or, you know, city officials. We can't control what people do. The only thing that document or what she agreed to on this show publicly could only be based on a woman's word and a man's word, you know. And so putting caveats above the dogs, saying sign something, she agreed to it. I thought it was all about the dogs. And none of us can determine the future and what happens in the future. And when it all plays out, because she's got legal representatives and stuff, in the future, it'll all play out and everybody will know the truth. Right now, let's deal with the dogs, man. Plain and simple. If we arrive at a building that's on fire, Danny, you're not going to say, put the fire out, then get the people out. You go in to a burning building and take care of the lives first and then deal with the fire, you know. But, you know, it's sad that the way that, you know, that mob mentality that happens on Facebook. Go ahead.
I have something to say.
Sure, dear.
I like how Paula raises her hand, even though we're in the virtual world. She's so polite. So, man, see, some of you people out there, you guys need some training, man. Mm-hmm. Go to Cotillion. Step your game up. See how she didn't raise her hand. Even she wanna. It's her show. She just, hey, I'd like to. Go ahead, Paula. I'm sorry. That's just hilarious to me.
That's okay. I mean, we've been dealing with some very, very rude people. But anyway, regardless of that. I want to say that I have had someone that I've been talking to for the last couple of days. This lady, and she's very, I call her that because she has shown much respect. She is helping me try to help the dogs. Good. And so we have, you know, we have some hope that these dogs in California are going to be getting help. And please don't anybody contact me and ask me to give you information, because it's not going to happen.
Yeah.
These dogs, I am keeping them private. They are in my heart, and I'm going to make sure that they get help if it's the last thing I do on this earth. Mm-hmm. So this lady and I are working on it. She's reaching out to some contacts that she has. So keep your paws crossed, say your prayers. Let's hope that these babies have good homes that they're going to be going to. So,
ruh-roh.
Paws crossed.
Is my favorite dog, Scooby-Doo ruh-roh would say, ruh-roh.
Yeah.
You know, hey.
I think we're going to try to take a break real quick, but when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit about the puppy mill issues back in the news. So we're going to talk a little bit about
that. Is that the NBC thing?
Yeah, today's
NBC,
show.
Today. Today. Yeah. Hey, today.
Joker, all right. Jokers with these
today's show,
puppy parties.
We're giving tribute to...
Got to handle some of this business.
Yeah, so Kathy Lee and Hoda, and we want to say, Kathy Lee, we send our condolences because the gift was a gift. You know, he was the man, you know, and
you got to be the man. You're going to hang out with Howard Cosell, man. That dude had a mouthpiece from another world. And you're sitting there in the same booth with him getting it in. Much love to Frank, whatever your detriments or fallback or parts of your personality people don't like, I'm like, man, you still deserve props, dude.
Yeah.
Put it down.
So. Yeah, they got a sports all-star game going on up in heaven right about
that's
now.
That's what's up. We'll be back. We're going to talk about this puppy mill stuff in the news with our guests Angelica and Antonio. We'll be right back.
Hey, are you tired of those same old energy drinks with bad taste? Make a switch to Pit Bull Energy Drink with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Pit Bull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale, lemon lime flavor, Pit Bull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Make a switch to Pit Bull Energy Drink. Pit Bull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale, lemon lime flavor, Pit Bull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products. For more information on Pit Bull energy drinks, bars, and mixes, visit their website at hiphopbev.com. That's hiphopbev.com. Online orders available at hiphopbev.com.
All right. Hiphopbev.com.
All right.
I want to get HipHopBev.com, radio voice like that.
That's hey, so we were talking with Angelica. She wanted us to talk a little bit about this stuff. I actually saw this on TV, but I didn't
put the pieces together.
I put them together, but I was on my own hype, so I was like, man, I'm not even. These dudes are up to no good again, mm-hmm. or whatever. But basically, they ran a show where they were talking about these puppy parties. I don't know if you've ever heard of them. They've been going on for a long time. It's nothing new, but they were talking about. Puppy parties, which is essentially parents, uncles, aunts, or whatever, mm-hmm. are basically to enhance their parties for their kids, as opposed to, you know, going to get SpongeBob SquarePants or a clown or whatever. They're getting little puppies to basically bring to the party so the kids can play with and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Now, on the surface, you would say, hey, that's cool. Like, that's better than little puppies and little kids or whatever. But the thing is that as opposed to these animals coming from shelters or from rescue groups where they could actually provide some education for kids and whatnot, a lot of these commercial entities are getting in and starting to cash in on this, and they're basically getting these animals from puppy mills and pet stores and things like that. And you know, there's kind of like a little bit of a hoofla or backlash or pushback against the Today Show and other organizations which are pushing this as, like, even though it's some, like, they probably thought it was just like a little trendy spotlight story, they're starting to see this whole evil underbelly that we all kind of know about the puppy mill problem and where these animals are actually coming from. Like, if you want to go get 10 cute cuddly puppies or whatever, like, even if they say, hey, you know what, these animals, they're coming from the, what is it, like, USDA regulated, mm-hmm. like approved organizations or whatever, as you know from countless episodes of this show talking with Fred Cray and whatnot, even those regulations and stuff that the government has don't preclude animals from being tortured and put into little pens and being subjected to cruel behavior. So it doesn't matter if they're approved or from anything. It's about where these animals are coming from and what they're being used for. And you're starting to see some corporate entities and commercial entities begin to capitalize upon this. Instead of clowns, like, they're driving clowns out of the business, but that's even less of a point than it is that you guys are helping contribute to the puppy mill problem. And that's a no-no. Well, whoever it is that's there to entertain kids, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I don't go to kids' parties like that. So, you know, like, whoever's, I'm sure they still got the jumper. Dude who has the inflatable jumper, he's probably still doing good.
Wait a minute.
Like,
so
Bozo is.
Jinx can't get work?
But what? I wanted to talk to Angelica about this. Like, what were some of your thoughts? You said you had a friend that started hitting them up about it.
We wanted to do a shout out to Lil Olive for actually bringing this to our attention. And she suffered a lot of backlash from it because her mom had posted a picture on the webpage to kind of say, hey, you know, my dog is a puppy mill dog. This is where these puppies are coming from. And her picture, the beautiful, beautiful dog, Lil Olive. Look her up on Facebook if you don't know who she is. And the picture was marked as, what did I say? as a
ugly, too offensive.
Yeah, offensive. The picture was marked as offensive.
And they do that to me a lot.
Yeah, and it's just, it's sad, you know? It's like, yeah, there's a little poster out there that runs around on Facebook and Pinterest, whatnot. It's like, you know, a picture of all these cute little puppies, you know? You think we're cute? You should see our parents. And they show these dogs in these cages with, like, one eye and looking all ratty. And it's like, people need to be educated to know where these dogs are coming from.
Mm-hmm. And the thing is, it's too, it's like, I mean, it's kind of like the state that media is in now where these stories, they get picked up and you don't necessarily, they don't even go through the time to research them and figure out, oh, am I covering all the right angles, even doing their journalistic, you know, duties or whatever. I think they said like the initial story was in from like a Wall Street Journal article about puppy parties. And then, you know, but then you've got one of the most popular media shows in the world, basically, during their happy-go-lucky portion of their show where they talk about, like, hey, this is the new, like, kids' fad, or this is the new, like, clothes that kids are wearing for back to school. You've got this segment that deals with an issue that has an underbelly that's actually very ugly, and you bear some responsibility for that. I understand that you can't always control, like, what, you know, what's going out on the air and stuff like that, but you're a global entity with a lot of power and money. You should at least, like, do some basic due diligence to know that, yeah, you know what? These puppies are coming from puppy mills, and renting dogs for your kids' party, it may not be the best idea. Like, and I know that there are organizations like rescues and shelters that do the same thing, but they come with an educational component where these dogs, they're not also always these purebred, like, fluffy dogs. They're the dogs that really need the help, or they want to they'll say, hey, yeah, we can bring some dogs from the rescue or from the shelter to your party so the kids can learn some things and see what the rescue community is about. But you know, you guys peddling this stuff for commercial purposes and this prime time news tabloid kind of show that you piece that you did is kind of a no-no. And I just want to put you guys on blast. And it's not a good thing. The puppy mill thing is real, and it's sad. And for people that are generally not aware of this stuff, which is probably like 90% of your viewers, you're really doing them a disservice by coming out the box, like not doing your basic due diligence with this stuff. So, that's all.
Is it any way we can support your friend?
She asked, you know, to post on their page. You know,
what is their page?
The Today Show on Facebook.
Oh, okay. And about puppy mills.
And then, you know, it's posting her picture, Lil Olive. She's on Facebook, L-I-L, and then Olive. And just post her picture and say, you know, basically, this is where these dogs are coming from.
Hey, and they could post a Rosie picture.
Yeah, and definitely.
You know, post the Rosie picture. Post the link.
I still get teary-eyed.
Post the link on NBC to our show, Everything is Rosie. Yes. Okay? And let them see that, because they will see what the whole puppy mill and breeding thing is all about, you know. So,
and you could probably, I'm sure you could just probably Google the story if you haven't, you know, if it hasn't
seen it.
Crossed your mind or whatever, and just get a little bit of info about it. I think
Today Show's got a web Facebook page with all of their
I'm sure they're getting blasted on their comment section, but I know you know, you got some prominent organizations that are, you know, strong animal rights advocates, like Best Friends Society and stuff like that, that have written some nice articles and stuff about it. So I think Frank Batista or somebody like that, one of the co-founders, they've written some nice comprehensive articles, especially that are kind of geared for people that may not know about these issues, that kind of you know, like little editorials or commentaries that speak specifically about it. I didn't know about puppy mills until we went out to Chicago with the Puppy Mill Project and went for National Puppy Mill Awareness Day. And I got exposed to all this information and it changed my thing. But I had never been on pet store, you know, kind of like, you know, we don't do that. Like, but I got educated really quickly about it. And once you start learning about it and hearing Fred Cray talk about some of the regulations and and things that are in place, it'll change your whole life. And shows like the Today Show, you have the capacity to do some some good, and I'm sure you do a lot of good. I'm not completely bashing the show or whatever, but
right. Yeah. Oh no, I love
that's a low ball, like that's a softball. You got to be able to hit those out the park. Don't be
exactly.
Don't be slanging puppy mill dogs.
But people talk
in
about
prime time, please.
Yeah. And it's interesting because Paula and you and I got slammed about not doing research. Like we're real journalists or something, right? Like we have a staff, like we have a budget. You know, it's like we have a forum that allows people to come on and share about what's happening in the animal world. So if a show like NBC and Today Show, you know, Jesus Christ, I know Matt is making $10 million a year or something. So I know they got a whole team.
I mean, for the most part, like we have a forum and we enjoy like just talking and trying to bring some of these issues to light. But every once in a while, some things that are kind of like black and white pop up. And this is one of those things. And it's like, well, yeah, if you're comfortable talking about this and saying, hey, you know what? That's not right. Because you're dealing with something that's really basic and kind of, this is like low level mm-hmm. basic stuff that you should be getting. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I'm not mm-hmm. saying, hey, your opinion on the Iran deal is wrong or whatever. Like it's not like that.
Well, my opinion, I worked hard to make that deal happen.
I'm like, don't go puppy mill dogs. Is that too hard? Don't promote the companies that are doing it too. Can you do that for me?
Farms. It's a whole. That's as sad as the whole farm issue, farm animals, which we are going to really, really, really be getting into too.
Hey, did you see that? Oh man, that's what I wanted to talk to you about. Was did you see that dude, Johnny Knoxville from? What's it called? Jackass.
Yeah.
He's been up to it again, and he's I think he actually landed some jail time this time.
But that was kind of serious stunt.
Yeah, he's obviously an animal lover and whatnot. A few years back, he did a stunt down in San Diego where he climbed up on one of the freeway signs on the way mm-hmm. down to SeaWorld or whatever. Mm-hmm. And, you know, where they say, like, SeaWorld, like 3 miles or whatever. Like, he taped over it and said, SeaWorld sucks or whatever.
Right.
And they had to bring out the fire department and stuff to get him down. And he got in trouble. But he was trying to promote that film.
Right.
What's the film called?
Blackfish. Blackfish.
Yeah, so he was promoting that. But then recently.
Did you see Blackfish?
Yeah, last week he pulled a stunt and he blasted it out on Facebook or whatever that he was going to go do this. But he pulled another big stunt mm-hmm. with the same issue. Mm-hmm. So
and he's. On that, I wanted to say about Blackfish and the dolphins and the killer whales, we got. A great letter, actually, from a person who is from the Faroe Islands, where all of that is happening. And I'm trying to get him to come on the show. He says that, you know, we may have to do it in a little silhouette kind of a situation because he said his life
like
has been threatened.
Those old mafia documentaries?
Yeah, because like, he said
his voice.
Yeah, his life has been threatened because... You know, he's from the Faroes, and he's spoken out about the tradition. For me, the tradition is insane, you know, because tradition used to be, it's 2,000-year-old tradition, so that doesn't even make sense. But because, you know, traditionally, for a while there, you know, slaves were okay to own, mm-hmm. you know, so, and women couldn't, you know, vote, and women couldn't hold their head up, and all like a whole bunch of, you could buy a woman, you know, you could sell a kid, a little girl, so tradition is insane argument, but we're going to try to have them on to give a feedback, and Paula, I was hoping you contacted the ladies from women around the world against Taj.
Yeah, they were great guests. That was really cool. I'm sure they. It just got me thinking when I was watching that Johnny Knoxville stuff about the role that public figures have when it comes to social activism.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I don't think any of us would really condone or advocate like doing anything illegal to, you know. Forward any kind of agenda, mm-hmm. but there's a part of you that, especially when you hear like the frustration of people that are working so hard for these animals, to see somebody that has a lot to lose,
mm-hmm.
like putting his liberty and his safety, you know, at risk just to highlight
that point,
highlight a point, you know, and it's like, Well, you know, we know he's a crazy dude. He's also a dude who'll put firecrackers in his butt and, like, you know, do all kind of weird stuff
you
or whatever.
You did that on one
but
show, didn't
but
you?
But it's kind of like part of me is glad to see somebody that's a public figure taking an overt stance on an issue that they care about. That's not a selfish issue. Like, it's about the animals, and that's kind of cool. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
It's like he's not peddling nothing. He doesn't have a movie coming out. He's just a dude that likes animals and is tired of the BS. So.
Well, you know what Martin Luther King said? If you don't, the man that won't stand for something will fall for anything. You know, so stand.
What do you think, Angelica? Like, when you see public figures, like, do you wish more people would step out and say stuff, or do you kind of like?
Definitely. In fact, you know, always, you know, I thought, oh, I wish I was famous so I could draw attention to this, you know, or, you know, animals or whatnot. And I'm glad to see people, you know, using their gifts for good.
Now, he did get like 80 fire. They brought like 80 fire trucks to get him off the scaffold and all that stuff. So you are messing up with my tax dollars, partner. But
that's right.
I will forgive you this time because, you know what? There's a long way to that. A lot of that I would give for the animals.
That's
so.
Right.
But I ain't going to jail like your ass. You need
that's
to come, man.
Hey,
utilize some of your high friends in low places to get some videos out or
that's
something.
Right.
But he used the public. He's the Facebook as his primary way to disseminate the information.
Mm-hmm.
So he had his viral kind of swell of people that were waiting for him to go do this. So he had a whole bunch of eyeballs on him.
Yeah.
You know, when he was up here. And, highlighting these issues.
Yeah. Lastly, before we get out of here, I want to say, and I'm sorry because I was caught up in the whole hate, anger thing with, within rescue. So I totally left my notes because I was like, that's part of the whole. See, it takes so much of people's time and energy and distractions. The dog died. We want to, you know, give a salute and lift our glass to the Jack Russell Terrier who passed away the other day from the
Augie.
Movie. Augie. Yes, thank you. Augie, he's up in, puppy heaven, doggy
Rainbow
heaven.
Rainbow Bridge.
Rainbow Bridge, you know. So, Augie, you did good. And Augie was a rescue, you know that? Augie came from the shelter. They had him, Paula. They said they had him listed, you know, he took the temp test. And, you know, he was too aggressive, couldn't handle it, you know, put him down. And the trainer said, no, I can work with him. And look what happened. Oscar caliber performance. Augie, we love you, baby. And keep it rolling. You know, give a bark out to, you know, God, Jesus, Allah, Jehovah, Buddha, whoever you're, you know. Hi, Paula.
St. Ides.
Yeah. Hey, Paula, you got anything before we get out of here? I'm going to give it to Angelica.
Nope. I just want to see her give the baby kiss again.
All right. So, hey, Antonio, what you got to say, buddy? He says, I'm not a pit bull.
One last message, you know. If you can't adopt, foster. If you can't foster, sponsor. If you can't sponsor, volunteer. If you can't volunteer, donate. And if you can't donate, then educate. Everyone can do something to help save a life.
That's right. And
if you can't do any of that, step your bow tie game up at least. Look at these guys, man. That's that's impressive over there. Yeah.
Hey.
Got to start them young.
That's right. And in closing, Breeder X, episode 2 is coming. So, and actually, that's a good thing. We can change the energy. Everyone, I imagine, in the community can support efforts for educating the public and the world about animal abuse. You know, we all understand that, you know, and better treatment of animals and how the human-animal interaction really works and how important it is. So when you hear about episode 2 being released of Breeder X, our little series that, you know, our family here is trying to get out there to change the message, education through entertainment. Please support it. Please watch it. Pass it on to 100 of your friends. And, you know, who knows what will happen. But it doesn't matter. We're not about the money around here. we're going to survive anyway. Even if we have to end up with the Karen hands and, you know, on the homeless, we're still going to be doing this show. We'll be doing it from cardboard boxes or, you know, the back of a van or wherever, because we're about, you know, love and support and educating the public towards all of the animal issues. If you want to be a part of that, you know, we welcome you. If you don't, that's all right. So. Yeah.
I just want to say happy birthday, Grandma. I want to say happy birthday to my brother. His birthday is next week. Congratulations to Cheryl Huerta for her birthday. Mm-hmm. And for everybody else that helped make the show what it is, we appreciate you all, the viewers and the contributors and Fred and Regina and everybody.
And Elke, Elke in Germany, who's battling back, you know, recovery from cancer surgery. Hey, brother, we love you. We love everything that you and all your, you know, your group and organizations, you know, he's part of like three organizations, you know, animal organizations, pit bulls and other dogs and saving. So, brother, we with you. You can do it. You just put your mind forward, you know, be past the moment. You know, you beat the surgery. Now you're in recovery. You're here with us. So we love you, man. We love you. And know, you know, take the entire animal community's, you know, vibes right now that they send into you, you know, and just know it's all gonna be good.
And a last final shout out to my buddy Eden Clemens. He's got a role in the movie Straight Outta Compton that comes out this week. He's a cop, so I won't hold that against him. But much love to you, brother, man. It's a wonderful thing that the movie that he produced that I worked on just got nominated by HBO for best feature film at their independent film festival. So much love to Eni and my brother Hawk, who directed the film. And you guys, if you get a chance, go out and support Straight Outta Compton and
see
the movie.
NAA.
It helps out independent filmmakers us in a
universal way. Yeah. And they got extra police too. Also, I do want to say, I'm glad you mentioned the movie thing, because that's really what Danny and I are about. Our movie that I directed, and the title is appropriate for what we're talking about, The Happiness of Karma. You can go to my Foster Quarter page. We just got nominated as the official selection in Summer, the producer and lead actress in it. It's going to hate me because I don't know the festival, but I'll tell you guys, go to Foster Quarter page. It's The Happiness of Karma.
Karma's a you-know-what.
Karma, okay? That's why. And when that film got nominated, that was one of the things, Paula, that came to me that said, why am I doing this angry thing with, you know, why am I putting myself in a position to be attacked? Why am I attacking these people? That's not where I come from. That's not where I live at. That's not where my life has been. That's not what I have been about as a being, as a soul, as a spirit. Happiness of karma. That's who I am. That's what I live for. So, again, you know, think about your own karma. What you put out there is what you get back. So, one love to you guys. You take care. And remember, we are pit bulls.
We approve this message. Deuces.
I'm a pit bull, and I approve this message.